With Randy Orton saying Matt Riddle disrespected him backstage, Hornswoggle's Saudi Arabia match canceled, and Kurt Angle recalling his shoot wrestling match against Brock Lesnar, this is Wrestling Up. My name is John, and you're watching the Wrestling Report for April 29th. Before we get into the rest of the video, make sure you subscribe to Wrestling Up and turn on all notifications to stay up to date with everything in the world of pro wrestling. On the Kurt Angle show, Randy Orton appeared to talk about his first interaction with Matt Riddle, which led to Randy feeling disrespected by the up-and-comer. But the funny thing with Riddle is when I first met him, we were in Miami. The entire locker room of NXT was in Miami. So now our locker rooms, which aren't the biggest, aren't jam-packed with NXT guys, who aren't working the show, but you know, in the wrestling business, you bring your gear to the show. You are always prepared, brother, and so you got all these NXT guys with all their stuff taking up all the space in the locker room. Me, especially being a vet, being around for a while, and I see this, and now I already got a hard-on for these guys, right? So it doesn't help when I walk by Matt Riddle, and my olive branch was basically me all looking at Matt. And I just said, oh, there he is. There he is, just kind of an icebreaker, expecting maybe a, hey Randy, my name is Matt, nice to meet you. But instead, Matt just kind of barely, you know, with the bloodshot eyes, glanced over me. He is just like, and just kept walking. I remember thinking, that motherfucker. So for quite a while, I didn't like Riddle, and it was because of that little scenario. One little incident, and it wasn't even an incident. It's just I took it as a lack of respect, and when you come back here, and you're brand new, and no one knows you, you want to introduce yourself because we're a band of brothers. With Riddle and Orton in a program together as a tag team, it's safe to say issues from their initial meeting have been resolved. When it comes to his pending trial, former WWE star Alberto Del Rio has broken his silence on the allegations against him, saying this to Lucha Libre Online. "It was a problem between my partner and I in which unfortunately I made a mistake. I committed infidelity in our own house that caused anger, resentment, and excessive hatred of the person who was supposed to be the woman of my life lifetime. After all the scandal happened and I was accused of what I was accused of, she dropped the charges a few weeks later. Although I was dying to tell the world that my ex-partner dropped the charges, I was not allowed to do so, as not to interfere with the case we are handling here in San Antonio, Texas. She dropped the charges. She did not just drop them, she had the courage to speak to the authorities and told them that it was for domestic violence, but that at no time was there a kidnapping because we had lived together for a long time and that there was never an assault. That this rumor that is out there is ridiculous about me trying to affect her son, little Matthias, the boy was not even in the house. Del Rio is rumored to be due in court May 3rd and will be wrestling Andrade in July." As Daniel Bryan looks to challenge Roman Reigns for the Universal title on SmackDown, it has been stipulated that if Bryan loses, he must leave the brand. Now the champion has posted on Twitter with a picture of the calluses on his hands, writing, "Trained, abused, and calloused. These are the hands that were built to end Daniel Bryan's career." When it came to his AEW debut, Christian Cage was unsure if fans would even care, revealing a conversation with Cody Rhodes helped put him at ease. "I get there straight onto a bus. It's nerve-wracking. You're like, will anybody even care that I'm here? You add those kind of thoughts that kind of go through your head a little bit. And it was funny, I never put this into perspective, but Cody came on the bus to talk to me briefly. This made me feel great. He said, it's a big deal that you're here. I was like, yeah? And he said, put this into perspective. For guys like you and I, it was Hogan, it was Andre, it was Macho Man, it was Ted DiBiase, all these superstars, the majority of the talent in that locker room, that is what you are to them, that same way." And I was like, whoa, I didn't really think about it like that. So that just kind of put me in a whole different headspace as far as going out there. It gave me some confidence. Not that I was lacking, but I was like, okay, yeah, cool. I made the right decision, and it was neat to walk through the common area and see all the faces kind of light up when I walked through. That was a very cool moment and really meant a lot to me. With him signing a multi-year deal, Christian will be looking to outwork everyone in AEW for a while. As the man formerly known in WWE as Big Cass made his Impact Wrestling debut, it has been reported by Fightful that he has signed a contract with a company with it said he signed and will be around for the foreseeable future. With him gaining momentum since returning to wrestling with a great physique, it'll be a treat to see him on TV in the ring for the first time since his WWE departure in 2018. Adam Pearce has been getting a ton of exposure as the on-air authority figure for WWE. He's also been a producer and apparently has impressed enough to be eligible for a promotion. While this has been rumored, no mass email has been sent internally to inform anyone of said promotion. Ringside News was told that doesn't mean it hasn't happened. With them adding, we've heard a rumor about Adam Pearce getting a promotion in WWE. We've asked around about that and we're told that hasn't happened. At least nobody has been informed yet. Pearce is a producer. Vince likes his on-air work because it's incredible. He's also different in the role. WWE is determined to give those in Saudi Arabia the biggest shows year after year as Fightful reported a match for Hornswoggle was nearly set in place. There were plans for WWE to run a match with Hornswoggle on one of those shows. Robbie the Giant was actually flown over to Saudi Arabia and not used, according to Talent. He appeared on Micro Championship Wrestling and appeared on WWE TV in the past as JB Elf. While speaking to Hannibal TV, Kurt Angle touched on his shoot wrestling match that took place against Brock Lesnar. As the Olympic gold medalist recalled, Brock and I are good friends. We weren't friends at the time, but when he first came into WWE, somebody approached him and said, "Hey Brock, how do you think you'd fare against Kurt Angle?" And he said, "I'm too big for him. I'm a lot bigger than him. He's too small. I'd kick his ass." The person that Brock told that to came to me and told me what Brock said. I went to Brock and said, "Let's settle it in the ring. Let's do it right now." And he said, "I can't. I have sandals on." I took my shoes off and said, "Let's do it in bare feet." He said, "I'm not going to do it in bare feet." A week later, I saw him in the ring talking to Big Show and walked up the steps to get in the ring. Big Show was facing me. I said, "Get out of the ring." Show got out of the ring and I walked up to Brock and I tapped him on the shoulder and I said, "Let's go." It was crazy. I caught him off guard, but the match was really tight. I'm not going to lie to you. There was only one takedown. We wrestled for about 10 minutes. There was a couple of times I almost took him down, then he fell into the ropes. I did take him down and that was it. And this was your Pro Wrestling News Update. I hope y'all having a great day. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you later.